Hi everyone, I'm Corbin and this is Plant Basics. In this video, I will show you how I keep my anthurium on trainings. I'll take you through my basic care tips, propagation and repotting, and also share some common problems and solutions with you. I'll put a detailed breakdown of all the elements of this video in the description for you, along with the timestamp. So that you can skip the part that's most important to you. Anthurium undranum is a very easy to care for an anthurium with gorgeous heart-shaped leaves and flowers, and they come in like a variety of colors from red and pink, white, yellow, and some are even stripy. And they're also capable of flowering throughout the year. Many of my plants have been in continuous flowers since I got them. All anthuriums are from tropical South America, where they can primarily be found as rainforest plants. All anthuriums produce flowers, but whereas the flowers of the foliage anthuriums like Clarinervium or Magnificum are less showy, the flowers of Anthurium on Dreum are extremely colorful, and they're also very long lasting when used as cut flowers. While all anthuriums can be found as either epiphytes, which means that they grow on trees but they do not take anything from the tree, lithophytes, which means that they grow in large boulders, or terrestrially, which means that they grow on the forest floor. And a fun fact, Anthurium undranum and Anthurium sphygianum are the only two scarlet anthuriums. Anthurium undranum loves bright indirect light without any direct sunlight. And this is also one of the tricks to getting your plant to flower continuously throughout the year. In my experience, one of the best places to put your anthurium is somewhere where it will get the indirect sunlight that comes through a sheer curtain. You can also place your plant in a sunless window where it will also get bright light, but keep away from direct sunlight because your plant can easily burn sunlight. And I can actually show you here what sunburn looks like on an anthurium leaf. So this brown patch. However, also note that if you place your plant in perhaps too much of a shady location, it could prohibit flowering and your plant will only produce leaves. I've actually heard people complain that the anthurium plants are very healthy and producing new leaves all the time, but they're not flowering. And the cause of this is usually diminished light conditions. The ideal temperature for your anthurium is between 18 to 25 degrees Celsius. It just makes them perfect for the home environment. Anthuriums love humidity, and you can increase humidity around your plants by spraying the leaves on hot days. You can also increase humidity by standing your plant on a tray of moist pebbles, and this will increase the humidity as the water evaporates around your plant. And the aim is really to keep the humidity above 50%. I run a humidifier in my office space where I keep my plants, because I've just found it to be the easiest way to increase the humidity effectively. But I did start out with a spray bottle, so it's fine when you're starting out, just spray the leaves a few times a day, but I think eventually you will want to kind of graduate to a humidifier. And you can even get a smart one that will maintain humidity at a specific level. Anthuriums like to be kept evenly moist but not soggy. I water my plants about once a week. When and how you water your plants will depend on your conditions. So if it is during the autumn months, your plants will most probably need more water than during the colder months. If your plant is in a clay pot, it'll need more water than if your plant is in a plastic pot, because a lot of the moisture will evaporate to the sides of the clay pot. The light conditions will also affect your plant's watering, because if your plant is in bright light, it will obviously photosynthesize a lot more and use more of the the moisture in the pot, whereas if your plant is in more diminished light conditions, it will obviously not grow at the same rate. But as a general rule, it's always better to be more on the dry side than be too wet. So I fertilized my Anthurium Andreum with a liquid orchid fertilizer. The high phosphorus content will help in flowering, because if you fertilize with a fertilizer that's too high in nitrogen, you do run the risk of your plant producing lots of leaves but not producing any flowers. I also like to use organic fertilizers like kelp or tea made from worm castings. The other thing you can also do is to have slow release fertilizers on the surface of your potting mixture that will gradually seep into the soil as you water your plant. So the ideal mixture for your Anthurium is something that is well draining and will allow for plenty of air circulation around the roots. I made this from Cocacoia orchid bark and potting soil to provide some nutrition, and then also a small bit of milled sphagnum moss. And I think that this is a very loose and well draining mixture. That is absolutely perfect for Anthuriums, because you don't want something that is going to compact too much and will not allow for the proper air circulation around the roots of your plants. So you take your Anthurium. This is an Anthurium I bought a while ago that's still in the nursery pot, and I'm going to pot it into this terracotta pot. This plant is slightly root bound with some of the roots coming out the edges of the pot. So to start off with, we are going to put some media in the bottom of the pot. And what I like to do is to place my plant in the pot to see that it's at the correct level, because you don't want to plant your plant too high or too low. Because if you plant your plant too high, you run the risk of any moisture simply running off the side. But also if you plant your plant too deep, you run the risk of the stems of your plant rotting away. So I'm now going to take my plant out of the pot and just press the sides of the container to loosen the roots. And we will, there we go. And as you can see, this is a plant with a very healthy, active root ball, because the root tips are in active growth. There are also no dead or diseased roots. So now you place your plant in the container, and I'm going to just put that there. I'm going to fill in growing media all around my plant. Okay. Now I've filled in a bit, and I'm going to press it down the sides to see what I still have to do. Okay, we're just going to put another layer over the top. Okay. So here you go, my plant is potted up into its new container. And when you do repottings, it's also a good idea to kind of look for any dead leaves or flowers and remove them to neaten up your plant. So I can just show you over here, we have some dead and brown flowers, and I'm simply going to pull them off at the base. Simply just going to pull this off. After you've repotted your plant, you want to give it just a little bit of water to help to settle the roots and to help them to get over the shock of being transplanted. There we go. So you can keep your plants clean by wiping down like the leaves whenever you see any dust build up. This will also help to keep your plant's matter free of any dust and will help your plant to photosynthesize better. Alternatively, you can also pop your plant into the shower about once a month. It's like give your plant a good showering and to free its leaves from any dust. One of the biggest problems with Anthurium on geranium is that your plant might not want to flower, and this could be down to a lack of adequate light. Anthuriums really need that bright indirect light in order to produce flowers. So if you have a plant that's not producing flowers, one of the solutions might be to move your plant to a location where it'll get more light and also hopefully produce more flowers. Another reason for a lack of flowers in Anthurium on geranium is a lack of nutrients. So if you fertilize your plant with a balanced orchid fertilizer or any fertilizer with a higher phosphorus content, it should encourage flowering in your Anthuriums. So pests I've noticed on my Anthuriums were mealybugs and scale. And I quickly tackled these with a soapy solution sprayed on my plants, like in the shower. But in general, I almost want to say that Anthurium on geranium is not as prone to pests as other plants. And usually when they have pests, it's quite quick to tackle because of the big leaves. You can easily wipe it down to remove things like spider mites. Another thing you can do is to give your plant a systemic insecticide to help combat pest pressures. So this is actually a plant I grow outside on my patio, so that's why it looks slightly disheveled, because it's exposed to the elements. But I'm going to use this plant to show you how to propagate Anthuriums through stem cuttings. I'm going to cut this plant above a leaf node, and the piece I'm going to cut does have some aerial roots that should quickly root if placed in a glass of water. So you can see this is a piece of stem. It has aerial roots coming out over there. These will grow out if placed in water. I'm actually also going to just take off some of these older stems. Yeah, and heaten it up a bit. Yeah, so this is a good Anthurium cutting. So now all that you do is you take a glass of water and you place your plant into the glass like that. But just a note on this is that you want to change out the water about once a week to keep it nice and fresh and to discourage any rot from setting in your cutting. Over here I can actually show you where a piece of stem has been cut off and a new stem has grown out the side from the leaf node below. My plant was exposed to some cold weather during our last winter, and that explains why some of these leaves have curled damage on them, but my plant did survive, and that tells me that Anthuriums are tougher than what people make them out to be. All parts of Anthurium on geranium is toxic, so make sure to keep them away from your pets and children. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you did, please hit the like button. And if you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section below. I always like to hear what you guys have to say.